probably will. Just so tired.
And as Jay said, you're never boring.
Well, thank you guys. You're so sweet. I'm supposed to give some bear pelts to someone. I can't find the quest. Where do I go to bring those bear pelts? I can't find the quest.
So cool with that keyboard on your chest.
I do. Do I look funny? Oh man, I just didn't know where to put it. What, you can't see me?
I can't see you at all.
Oh my gosh, somebody just said you rape on my YouTube.
Bam.
Do you, Never mind, I was gonna ask you for something.
What do you want?
Some meat or something. Meat. Some meat or Red Bull. I feel so weak. I feel like I'm like dying right now. I don't know why I'm so fatigued. I slept a full night.
You have Red Bull in here?
On top shelf. Oh, she is?
Some wings.
Some wings. Thank
yeah.
You.
I can see you.
Did you eat all the meat?
No. There's meat.
Yeah, meat.
You want some meat?
Maybe this Red Bull will help. I just had like no energy. It's gone. Lolly makes badges too. She owns the castle that's on your canvas. Which one do you think will taste better? Beef au jus, since you think it's called au jus. Do you like the pirate outfit I made? Thank you, Jace. I find it funny that she's in a Playboy Bunny costume. Because, the guy I used to be married to, he, loved watching me wear Playboy Bunny costumes. He would go on IMVU and buy me every Playboy Bunny costume he could find. This outfit that I have on in the shop, or not in the shop, in the room of the pirate, all I did was slap on a bunch of random crap. I look like a pirate. I swear, the names of the bunnies I have are so perverted sounding. Like, not even funny. Let me know if she says something, guys. The Red Bull is helping. I can't find... Does anybody know where to give them damn bear pelts? Tembo White Arms. Where's Tembo White Arms? Okay, objective marker, where are you? Where are you, objective marker? Where are you? Okay. I was like collecting all these stupid bear pelts. Did you just let one rip?
What kind of fool plays with fire like?
Friends like you are hard to find.
Brought you the bear pelts, just like that.
Nice to finally meet someone who can follow simple instructions. Here's your reward, as promised. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to work.
Earn more acts of sleeping. What's an iron war axe of sleeping?
If you get it.
Oh, 10 points.
Kill a few more bears for me, will you?
Kill a few more bears for me, will you? Sure, I'll kill your bears. Okay, so I'm gonna show you a trick, guys. Are you ready? So this wheat, all you do is harvest it. You don't, whatever you do, don't put it in this right here, that grind thing that guy's doing. Never do that. Because then it grinds that wheat into nothing, and then you can't use it for the potion. So, and they put it in like a sack of flour or something. It makes flour. Yeah, just don't do that. Just rip it out of the ground, take it. Same thing with these potatoes. If you take the potatoes and you get some salt, you can make a soup that will give you 10 points of health. And I think it's worth it, because it's very light, easy to carry, and, you know, after a while, unless you have cheats for your game, you know, you're gonna need more health potions. Like, you could never get enough health potions. So just take the things out of the ground, and then make a potion out of it. Same thing with these chicken eggs, it makes another potion, although I took them already, so... Michael, are you there? Jace, are you there? If you want to make elven arrows, you need to chop this up. Well, those shoes show off her legs more. I think when I have time, I'm gonna make a geisha outfit.
Just wants to see the world, just like I did when I was her age.
And if she decides to move, I must. What then? There is, I said a long time ago, we're gonna get
some ice and then we're actually going to be in
it. How come?
No, we're still watching you.
Sorry.
I was only trying to make some meat now, so I'll be your back.
Take your time. Thank you.
Hold on, Gagan.
I like how the guards say no lollygagging. My mom used to say that all the time. No lollygagging. Nope, no lollygagging. Nope, 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 nope. Nope, 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 nope. Nope, 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 nope. Nope, 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 nope. Sorry, just spilled something out of my hand. It was like, ah. That's really, like, shocked me. Let's see. Okay. No lollygagging. Nope, 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 nope. You like it when I do that, Jace? We go, nope, 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 nope. Nope. That's what you gonna say to your recruits, right? Nope. Seems like my food wants to crush you today, Michael. It's like smash.
The gods gave you two hands, and you use them both for your weapon. I can respect that.
Gods gave you two hands and you use them both for your weapon. I can respect that. Yep. Nope. Ragnarok. Nope. Okay, so we gotta find another mission.
Staying safe, I hope.
Cornered rat. Wow, what? Did you guys know that they found a real unicorn a couple years ago? I saw it on the news. They had it caged up, and it was really tiny, and it looked terrified. And you could see all these photographers just like, ooh, like this. And it's looking at them like it's gonna eat them or something.
Wanted to say something to you. I think you're all right. Pull up a chair, my friend. This is quite a tale. When I started out in this business, I wasn't really interested in the guild.
What's hard to believe? Well, look it up in the news. I actually was watching the news, and it was on international news. It actually came on the TV. It had videos and pictures and everything. To be honest, it was so scrawny. Kind of looked like a deer.
So, you're Brynjolf's new protege, eh? Don't look like much to me. Lot of people looking for him. Don't know his name, but he's paid good money for nobody to know he's down here.
Looking for wood. Stick with me, and he'll never even know you're there.
He was one of them asking about that old man.
Sweet.
this guild needs the coin. Walking away without taking
it's one thing to say you've got the skills to be a thief. It's another to actually... Lot of people looking for him. Don't know his name, but he's paid good money for nobody.
I'll see if I can find
down.
A picture of it for y'all.
He's holed up in the Rattway Wards.
Excuse
hardly
me.
Ever leaves the place. Has someone bring
it's really,
food
crazy old it looks terrified. They caged it up.
For that to stand out down here, he must really be off his nut. He's holed up in the Rattway Warrens. Be careful. You're not the only one looking for him. I don't know about the others, but I sure am glad to see a fresh face down here. The flagon used to be packed every night with the boys from the guild. But now, look at it. Last few years have been pretty bad. I've almost closed this place up.
I showed it to, my roommate, he had it for a while, though. Okay, here it is. Where is it? I just saw it. Here, I'll link it to you. It looks almost like a deer. It is on NBC or something. But I saw a video of it. It literally was looking around terrified.
All eyes are on you, lass. Don't disappoint us.
These solvers were like coming out of nowhere. Do you know my arrows, you faggots? Yeah, it was really sad that it's got a deformity. My mom's like, oh, they're gawking at that poor creature. And I'm like, yeah, well, you know. It made many dreams come true when he had that horn, so. Everybody wanted to see a unicorn. They actually named it Unicorn. I was like literally doing homework, watching the news.
Inkpot.
And that popped up in the news, and I was like, what?
Knife.
I was like, see, Mom? See, I told you that they're real. She kind of laughed at me.
No, never find me. Bucket, knife, book, ink pot, stone. No, no.
Go away! What? No, that's not me. I'm not Esbern. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not opening this door. Do you mind?
Please.
I told you to go away. I'm not opening this door for anybody. And no doubt you are one of them, huh? Leave me alone. What's that you said? Back and forth, then there really is hope after all. You'd better come inside.
Quickly now. Delmore agents have been seen in the Rathway.
This'll just take a moment.
Come here.
This one always stops.
There we go.
Yes.
Only a couple more.
Gee, can you get any more locks on the door?
There we are. Come in. That's better. Now we can talk.
Jeez.
You, Dragonborn. Is it really true? Important. Far more than even she realizes. If you are Dragonborn, then there is hope, after all.
Donkeys? What are donkeys?
Or
do you mean donkeys?
Dragon. They can be killed. The Blades killed many in their early days as dragon slayers. No, the dragons are merely the final portent of the end of days. Oh, yes. The prophecies make clear the signs that will precede the end times. One by one, I've seen them fulfilled. Alduin has returned, just like the prophecy said. The dragon from the dawn of time who devours the souls of the dead. No one can escape his hunger, here or in the afterlife. Alduin will devour all things, and the world will end. Nothing can stop.
Alduin's rage.
You see, you know, but you refuse to understand. You're right, I forget myself. I've lived without hope for so long. The prophecies are clear. Only the Dragonborn can stop Alduin. We must go quickly now. Take me to Delphine.
What?
We have much to discuss. Just a moment.
I'm gonna steal his food. It's like, I got no use for this trash. And you're telling me. He's like hauled up into this place.
One moment. I know time is of the essence, but mustn't leave secrets for the family. One more. Well, I guess that's good enough. Let's be off.
Rabbit leg. He was hungry, he was making a rabbit. What kind of girls did Alex sleep with? I mean, brown coming out of a lady's twat? That's disgusting.
Nothing!
You would think he'd lock the door if he's that afraid. So Michael's not talking, that must mean he might be doing something bad. Where'd you go, penis?
I was getting something to eat.
Oh.
Wait, you forgot that I once said I was gonna get something to eat.
Yeah, I forgot.
That's alright. What are you doing right now? Because it looks to me like you're staring at an inkwell.
Well, I'm supposed to escort that dude, but I'm like looking to make sure I didn't miss any books. Repeats of what?
Repeats of the same book over and over again.
I hate that. But some of these books will give you, like, it'll expand your map.
Oh, like give you new quest markers and stuff?
Like, yeah, it'll give you new quest markers and it'll give you, like, new, it'll open up parts of the map that you can't normally go in unless you look at those books.
I see.
Usually the pricier books like this usually have like map details, but sometimes the lesser ones, like $10 ones, do too. So you got a health potion right there. Children's and men. I love how when you go into the barracks, you find this book called The Lusty Argonian Maid.
Yeah, and it has so much innuendo.
Yeah. They put it right by the guy's bed, so that implies that he's doing something he shouldn't have. He's like, beep, beep, beep. Beating his meat. I want to get
he
a cook.
He was choking the chicken, stroking the log.
Choking the chicken?
Stroking the log. What is this Unideer thing?
What? What's happening?
Oh, I'm just reading this thing about the Unideer thing.
I can't hear you say it again.
I was just reading this thing about the Unideer. You know, the deer with one horn?
Yeah. It's a unicorn that they found, and it was all over the news. Have all this meat and no salt. Drives me up a wall. I really resent those storm Antiochs too. They're like all over the place. Even when it's on like your side, it's always in your way and it's bulky and annoying. I wonder if they have a water Antioch. Throw a tidal wave at someone.
That'd be a water Antioch?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know how to pronounce it. Antronach or Antir. You what?
I think it's called Antronach or something like that.
Why is Gizzer attacking us? Gizzer. Who's Gizzer?
I have no clue.
Something smells like barbecue. You're making bacon? Ward female believed to go by Carrie. Maybe an alias. Likely to be inquiring about Esteburn and the Rattoid. Do not approach. Inform your assigned contact immediately. Aww. Someone sent an assassin after me.
Wow.
And he was actually where all the other people were, all the other dudes.
Knife. Yes. Book. Yes. Bucket. Yes. Inkpot. No.
I'm gonna eat well tonight, my darling.
Holy shit. Okay, that rock dude is really annoying. What's with the chef trying to attack me?
The chef?
Yeah, there was a chef trying to kill me in these rataways.
What's kind of odd for a chef to be doing that?
What?
So that's kind of odd for a chef to be doing that.
Okay, I'm stuck. Again, see, this is why I hate the storm.
The storm Antronach?
Yeah.
He's not meant for enclosed spaces.
Can you shoot at him and be okay?
And probably not with Esburn being a dingus.
So don't shoot at him at the storm? Huh?
Egg is talking about the masturbation joke. Flapping the sausage.
Careful.
Good God, this thing is annoying. It does at least. She doesn't seem to be an enemy. I think just think you've been killing random people.
Well, it listed her as an enemy. Is that a bad thing?
Kind of.
Why?
They have no home. You're shooting homeless people.
So? Is Meg getting a bounty for that or something?
I don't think so, not while you're on a mission. Although I don't remember these people ever being hostile towards me.
Well,
maybe it's because you're a Stormcloak and they're Imperials.
Oh.
Gary Torita. You went way to the Empire.
Okay, let's see.
Don't you just love how he doesn't really care?
Who does? That
he stole a bunch of stuff.
Oh, that Esteburn doesn't care, or who doesn't care? I killed a deaf woman, yeah, well, probably did her a justice.
She deserved it.
Yep, she shouldn't have gotten hostile. I swear, if he does another Storm Antronach, I'm gonna be pretty angry. It said that I could do a head roll while I'm running and sneak, but I haven't been able to.
A roll? You have to sneak and then hit the sprint button.
What's the sprint button?
The one you can use to run faster.
No kidding. Is that left bumper or right bumper? What? Jeremy, what button is the sprint button?
Maybe it's the left bumper. I'm not quite sure.
I may have it turned off, sprint, because I'm pressing left bumper and nothing happens.
Okay, you can hit start and see your controls, I think. Your options to figure out which one it is. I know for the computer, it's left alt. But it's been so long, I can't.
I just pressed the B and it doesn't work.
Okay, let's see here. Sprint is what now?
Left bumper.
Okay. So, going to sneak?
I am in sneak. Okay.
And walk in the direction you're supposed to go.
Still have not done a roll.
Maybe tap it while moving forward. Oh, you have to do it right as you're moving forward.
I am. Nothing's happening.
Okay, stand up.
Okay.
Try to sprint.
Stand up and try to sprint.
And you should see your stamina bar going down.
Okay, that worked.
Very odd. Okay. And it's not working when you're. Can you switch to third person to see?
Yeah.
Like that?
Hold on.
Is it still not rolling?
I'll try in a second. I gotta get out to the cistern where there's more room. Still not letting me.
Ah, you made it. Good to see you, my friend. I'll never forget how
you
saved
me. That's very odd.
How many
years? Because I know for me, left alt is my sprint button on the computer. It's also the button I used to roll. Wait, do you actually have the perk unlocked?
Yeah. Yeah. You won't trigger any plates. Oh, that's weird. I thought that's probably because I didn't save.
Oh, and it's not unlocked anymore.
55 sneak. There we go. I was like, what's going on here?
We figured out the problem.
That's pretty cool. I'm gonna go back down. So I can rank up again. I gotta pay that dude.
see you again, friend.
Hey, one dude. I'm not quite sure what the dude is.
He's the guy that furnishes everything.
Oh. I like how just one cheek sticks out of your robe.
It's like a tease, I think.
Because I don't think Nocturne was ever meant to, you know, sneak. So they didn't build the robe for sneaking.
One of these guys, not Brynjolf, it's
So, you're Brynjolf. It's one thing to say you've got the skills to be a thief. It's another to actually...
It's one of these guys. I think it's this one, Delvin.
Got lots of jobs available.
Stick
with me, and he'll never even know you're there.
Oh, I've reached my max number of sneaks.
Where are you off to?
I hate when that happens.
Look, I need to know. What's going on between you and Brynjolf?
How dare you? After all we've been through together?
Yeah, Arn is very smart when it comes to Skyrim. He's like the Skyrim guru.
Something.
So, is it true?
And back. Sorry about that.
Welcome back.
Somebody came home, and my sister's now getting a stern talking to.
Why? What happened? Did she do that?
Because she wanted to go to some sort of formal thing. I'm not quite sure what it's called, but she had to buy a ticket for it. My mom was about to let the $20 thing slide, but then she
Who's
found
that?
Out she didn't do any of her chores, but like she said she did. She literally just shoved everything into the corner.
Shove what in the corner? Why is that woman attacking me? That is the E person.
Who is this E person? Who is that female Thalmor leader?
Oh, I know what you're talking about. It's good. Really good. That guy was ready for her before I was ready for her. Yeah, most girls are like that, sadly. Let me tell you something about girls. Guys, girls are vicious with a capital V. Thank you.
Except my sister. My sister is only vicious to her own family.
Oh, they're all animals. I know what I mean. I'm pretty much the most laid-back girl you'll ever meet. Most of the girls are nasty and mean. Like, I hate... I've had roommates before, boys and girls, and, you know, people say, oh, boys are messy. Yeah, they're messy, but they're more sane, I think, than most girls.
Yeah, they're less likely to try to, you know, backstab you.
Yeah, if you if you're a girl and you live with a girl, that's like asking for a death sentence.
Yeah, I was gonna say, when a guy is gonna punch you, he's gonna punch you in the face. If a girl's gonna hit you, she'll literally just stab you.
Yeah, if a girl wants to get you, she's clever and nasty about it. Like, they're really vicious. They can't just knock you in the mouth. They have to knock you in the mouth and get you from behind, and destroy your shit, and ruin your life, and tear it down.
And I'm the same way, Jace. All my games have its own little thing. My books have their own little thing.
You're not supposed to play with fire, you know.
My clothes has its own little bin thing, but that bin is a little bit, has a little bit too much clothes in it, so it's slightly overflowing.
Fandolf thinks he can Valerius away from me. She's already mine, I keep telling you.
Whatever I'm currently reading is on the bed.
Like, I had some crazy female roommates. Crazy with a capital C.
It's good to see you too, Esbern. Let's see what Esbern has to say.
Mm-hmm. Well, then.
Like, literally, they've gone.
Come on, I have a place
for and
you. Orgnar, hold down the bar for a minute, will you?
Ripped yeah, up sure. My clothing.
This way.
Stole my underwear, so that way, like, I mean, I was in the locker room one time taking a shower, and they stole my underwear, so that way I'd be bouncing on the bus all the way ride home.
Wow.
And then when I was in college, my roommates thought it would be funny to pee in my food that was in the fridge.
The fuck?
Yeah, they peed in the food. They took some of my favorite towels and ripped them apart.
What's it like if I pissed in their food?
Let's see what Esbern has to say.
Like now, in my shitty chocolate bar?
I assume you know about.
They would take my clothes and throw them on the floor. Or they'd pull them right out of the washer while it's still washing. And they would use my soap that's already in the washer to wash their clothes. And they would use my soap to wash all their clothes, and then they'll be like, don't be using my staff, and magically my detergent would disappear, which of course, it didn't magically disappear. Yeah, they just claimed it to be their items, and then yet their items would never go down. I used to have this thing called a pure water filtering system. It was like a pitcher. You put a filter, and then you put water in the pitcher with the filter, and it trickles down into the basin below.
What are you getting?
Nope.
They
broke it. They took it, scratched it up, banged it so that it would leak a little bit, and had all these cracks on it. And then they peed in the water, and I knew that that wasn't how the water was supposed to taste, because I had those at my parents' house, and the water tasted like urine. It was disgusting. And then this...
How fucked up are you?
This was in college, huh?
You could have had the police on them and arrested them.
Oh, they were crazy. Like, one...
How crazy they are, they would have been arrested by the police.
So you think that Alduin's wall will tell us how to...
We told... I called the resident... I had so many, like, talks with the resident assistant and resident director. The resident assistant is, like, the warden of that building. And the resident...
Near what's now known as Karth Spire,
of the dorm, the resident director of the dorm is in charge of all the dormitories, like, of all the buildings. And so...
Yeah,
like,
road south, I would have went to the rest of the building. I would have went directly to the police.
Or you could catch the carriage from Whiterun to Markham and then approach.
Well, I tried to get moved, and they were like, oh, it's a $300 fee. I said, I don't have that, and I didn't want to get the police involved because the police in Florida don't do anything. No offense to police officers, but literally, I've seen them let crime go on.
Don't worry. Huh? We'll get Esbern there in one piece. We'll wait for you in your car's fire.
Well, eventually, what they did was, they literally took, like, I took them in the dorms and I said, look, they're doing this, and this, and I don't understand why we can't have shared laundry days. Like, so for example, I get maybe Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, they get Thursday, Friday, Saturday, you know, and then Sunday is a free day for anyone else. They did not want to share at all. They're like, you know, we had three roommates. I said, okay, everybody gets 2 days to themselves, and then Sunday be the wild card day so that if somebody really needs it, they can use it. And the girl, she looked like a younger version of Michelle Obama, and she had short hair, like a pixie cut, and she was like, no, I want to use it every day. I have a lot of clothes. I have more clothes than you, so therefore I should be able to use it every day of the week. I said, but you're leaving your clothes in the washer, and I'm not going to move your clothes because you yell at me if I touch any of your stuff, and I don't want to touch your stuff anyway. And she was just like, you know, pissy that I said that to her. And I said to the director, I was like, look, you know, I'm not asking for much here. I think my request is fair. She goes, no, it's not. She freaked out because I said this and took me and pushed me into a wall. And I got a bruise. And then I said, huh?
That's where I would have started collecting evidence.
Oh, I took pictures.
And if the police won't do anything about it, I would go above them.
Yeah,
people above that wouldn't do anything about it, I would take it to the fucking Supreme Court. Because that is bullshit.
Well, their mom and dad were actually judges. Like, one of them had a mom for a judge and a police, and her dad was a police officer. So they thought they could get away with anything.
Yeah, they would not be able to have any leeway with the Supreme Court.
It was outrageous, and
for one, you're violating a student's rights for doing that. For another, that's willful destruction of personal property.
Oh, I agree. And they were just like, oh, why can't you just deal with it? I'm like, no, I really can't just deal with it. Sorry. And,
yeah, that's not how colleges should be. Colleges is for learning, not for people to play Asshole Simulator 2012.
Asshole Simulator 2012. Well, what they did was after she pushed me in the wall, I was like, you know, you owe me. You should be allowing me to move or making them move. And they're like, okay, we'll let you can move. And they gave me no assistance to moving whatsoever. And so I had to pack up my own stuff after only being there for like 4 months or less, maybe give or take. And so what they did was they blew up hundreds of these like little balloons and they put them all in front of my door. So that way when I would come out, I'd slip and break my head. And I said, stop with the fucking balloons. And they laughed and they said, no, my hallway. Get out. I said, I'm trying to get out, but you need to, like, stop with the pranks and stuff. Because I'm going to slip and break my head. And they thought that was funny. And so they kept doing it.
See, now they're starting to get into personal injury. That's another lawsuit against them.
Right, and I was coming out and I'm holding boxes, you know, you can't see what's underneath you when you're holding them giant cardboard boxes. And so I actually slipped. I stepped on a balloon, slipped, not seeing it, and almost broke my neck. And I almost broke my neck and, you know, I was livid, and I said, I told you to stop putting them fucking balloons in front of my door. And they thought it was funny, so I pulled out, like, a butter knife and started stabbing all the balloons. Is that or a fork? I can't remember. It wasn't sharp. It wasn't... I mean, and I did have an actual knife that wasn't mine. It was my ex-fiance's. And, it was within the 4-inch limit. Like, you can have a switchblade in Florida as long as it's within the 4-inch limit. Like, it can't be larger than 4 inches. So...
Like, the blade can't be larger than 4 inches.
Yeah, so they call police on me. And they were like, oh, this girl's waving a knife around and she's dangerous and all this stuff. She's crazy. And then in comes the police busting down my door with a SWAT team. A SWAT team. I was like, the fuck? They grabbed me and I said, hey, you know, and they were going to try to, like, forcefully hurt me. And I said, hey, you don't need to hurt me. You could just tell me what you want and I'll do it. And they were like shoving me face against the wall like this. Where's the weapon? Da-da. I said, what weapon? And they're just like, we were given a report that, you know, you were waving knife around or something like that. And they made it seem like I was like some horrible person. And I was like, no.
That's...
And they literally...
information of character, as well as police brutality.
Yeah, and they literally frisked me in every imaginable spot, looked in my privates for it, and I was just like, what is it that you want? They're like, where's the knife? And I showed them the knife. They're like, you don't have any others? And I said, yeah, I have one packed away that's, you know, my ex-fiance left here, and... I showed it to them. They said, tell us the truth. Cooperate. We won't hurt you. And I still told them the truth, and they still hurt me. And it hurt me because you're, like, forcing me against a wall, pinning me there as if I'm, like, some terrorist. And so I got pretty angry, and I told them, I was like, you know... I told them literally that I didn't do anything to deserve this. And I said, look at the records. These girls are known for being disruptive. They've actually had to have 6 roommates kicked out before me. They had 6 different people that came out.
And I bet you that the police still didn't do anything.
Well, one police officer... figured out that they were reverse racist. Do you know what that means?
They're people of a different race hating white people or something like that.
Yeah, they're like... They're not white supremacists, they're black supremacists.
Which is dumb because... I personally believe the RAs should be equal. It's,
well, the RAs were black and they were black. And the police officers figured out, because I swore an oath and I was honest with them, they figured out the truth that these girls were actually legitimately, like, fucking crazy.
Yeah, and I'm not sure why, but your crosshair is different from where your center of aim is.
Oh, I know, it's been that way for a while.
That should not be like that. Did you get any different camera or something?
Say what? A camera mod? What's a camera mod?
You know, a modification for the first-person camera.
Does it do?
It would change the height of your camera and the crosshair, where the crosshair would be. Did you get one of those? Because if so, that might be what's causing the bow to, you know, misalign with the cursor.
No, I didn't get one of those. I only used what you gave me.
You may have to get this enhanced first-person camera thing that I occasionally use. Because it doesn't affect the mod, but it does allow you to be able to see your body from, like, where your head would be.
Well, if you can find a good one, you try it out first and I'll do it.
I'll just send you the one that works with the scope pose mod.
Okay. So anyway, as I was saying, these girls had literally called the police 6 other times before me, per every other girl that was staying in that room, and the girls were so fed up with it that they just paid the $300 and moved. They didn't, I love this mammoth cheese. It's so good looking. But yeah, like, I just literally was so... They were so fed up with the girls, they would just move and pay the money. But I couldn't pay the money to move, so that's why I was experiencing it. And so the police officers threatened the girls, and they were like, look, we know you did this so that way you don't have to have a third roommate, so you can get reduced rent. And we're tired of you wasting our time. This is the Orlando PD. And, they were like, we're not going to, they said the next time you call us, not me, but them, they said, he said that they're gonna, like, they're gonna take action and throw the girls in prison. That's what they said. They're gonna throw them in the jail for a night, per every time they do it.
Yeah. Just a night, like a couple of years, because that is just horrific.
Oh, I know. And so the girls were very angry with me because. Sweet. What?
They're gonna be angry at you for shit they're doing.
Well, they were angry because they couldn't get me arrested. And the police officer actually felt really bad for me because he knew that they were being racist and he knew that what they were putting me through, so he helped. He's like, I'll give you one car ride over to your new apartment. So he, like, actually let me ride in the car and help me lift my stuff and go into the other apartment. He was not supposed to do that, but... Yeah, so it was nice. He was like the only really sane cop I met. I mean, I maybe met one other, but other than that, most of them.
Yeah, that fox is wily.
Yeah, that fox is hard to get. But yeah, so he did that, and so the girls were angry, and they couldn't succeed in, you know, screwing me over. So they went to the college and said, oh. This nasty roommate of ours was waving a knife around, and so they were like, the college was like, oh, since this, you know, the police were called, you can either fight their claim, and, we can, like, you know, you can fight their claim, or you cannot fight, like, basically I was gonna be on probation with the school, which means I couldn't join any sports. And that's pretty stupid. They're like, yeah, we won't let you join any sports or watch any sports. If you are on probation. They put me on probation automatically without even hearing my side of the story. Only because that's what they do. Because the school is stupid. So, they put me on this probation.
So their policy is guilty.
Right, that's their policy. Guilty until proven innocent. This is the University of Central Florida for you. And it's stupid. Very, very stupid. And I got angry. The guy who they convinced to do this to me was black, and they were black. So, he automatically took their side, and he's like, look, you could fight the ticket. He said there'd be 3 judges... plus the girls and me, and if they felt that I was innocent, I would be let go and they would be penalized. But if I could not convince them judges that I was innocent, then they'd throw me out of the university. Like, completely expel me from the school.
So they stacked the whole cards against
Right, and they were just like, oh, well, you know, you can, like, but if you don't want to go through that trial, they're like, you could just plead guilty, and we'll give you a sentence of, you have to join two clubs and go to these classes about how to avoid conflict. Some stupid ass shit. I'm like, really? Like, I didn't even do anything wrong. And I knew that, I could tell by the way the guy talked to me that he was going to take those girls' side over me no matter what, because I wasn't black and they were, and he was black. So it was just like, why fight it? So I was like, okay, I'll do it. But, you know, it's actually harder than it looks, because when you go to college, you're busy as fuck. You have, like, no time to do anything. You can't sleep, you can't eat, you can't do nothing. And it was exhausting, so I couldn't do it. So they put an academic hold on my account. And they were like, alright, you can't register for classes until you come in and explain what's going on. Oh, that's why they're mud crabs. They actually jump out of the mud.
If they sort of like hide themselves inside the mud, they sometimes they look like rocks.
That's weird. But yeah, so I was just like, fuck it. But then, you know, I got married, and when I came back, I was like, you know, these are the reasons why I couldn't do it. I was injured, yada yada. And they said, like, I was agitated, but he's like, alright, well, you still gotta finish your sentence. And I'm like, okay. And then I never did it, because I never could do it. And so they're like, okay, if you want to go back to the college now, you can't register for any classes at all until you do this penance. And I was just like, okay. That's stupid. And yeah.
Yeah, it is stupid. Give me a second.
Skeletons. So yeah, I mean, I plan on going back eventually, but, you know, right now, my health is number one, and to be honest, I couldn't give a rat's ass if the guy is pissed off that I didn't go to these stupid classes. I think it's retarded. And, you know, like, there was a police report that said I was innocent, and yet they're just like, oh, well, this drama happened, so we're gonna, like, take it out on you, blah, blah, blah. So, he can suck it. But, yeah, I mean, when my health is at stake, like, the last thing I care about is someone's stupid penance. But yeah, you know, I mean, I'll get it done eventually. I mean, I do want to go back to college. It's just, I really wish they would have just looked at the police report and let it go. I'm just gonna go and kill this dragon. Thank you. gotta get out of here. That was a retarded way to die. Ebony gauntlets? Huh. Welcome back. But yeah, oh, you wanna hear something funny? I'll tell you something really funny. So, like, these girls were so crazy, they expected, like, the whole world to accommodate to them. So, the one that looked like Michelle Obama, you won't believe what she did. So, she had this boyfriend, and she actually wanted to try to, like, look good for him or whatever. So, she actually called up the apartment complex and asked to install a stripper pole. A stripper pole. Yeah, they said, no, we cannot do that, that's a liability, blah, 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 blah. And he was like, she's like, well, fine then. So she tried to install one. And it was really funny because she tried to install it and she couldn't do it right. So when she did it, literally, she installed it and she didn't do it properly. So she got up on the stripper pole and started dancing on it in her bedroom, but she had the door open, and I walked by, and just as she goes up to do a spin, boom, the thing just goes and falls over, and it fell on the ground, and I caught her falling with the whole pole right on her head and her ass. She was just down. I was dying of laughter. She's like, shut the fuck up and get out of here, Fury! And she was so mad. It was so funny. She was like livid that I would laugh at her. I almost thought it was great. Oh shit, there comes the mammoth. Man, that mammoth is fast. Oh shit, don't let it fall on you.
At least we haven't seen you, you know, becomes part of the space program this time.
What becomes part of the space program? Or you mean when they launch, when they throw you?
When they launch you in the air, because they hit you so hard with the globe. It's one of the most amusing glitches in the game, to be honest.
Oh, I know.
And they actually done it to where, with the Space Corps, if that giant hits the Space Corps, it'll go up into space and be happy.
That's funny. But yeah, when she landed with the thing like fucking falling on top of her. Oh, I laughed so hard. Oh, I know. It's just like, what the hell are you doing with your fucking stripper pole? First of all, you should be in college, not practicing for stripping. If you have to get on a stripper pole to get your guy to like you, something is clearly wrong with you. Like you Yeah. You're telling me. NFTs. And lavender. Huh. But yeah, I find it hilarious that you buy, like, a cheap ass stripper pole and then it falls on you. That's like, that made my day. I'll never forget that. Ever. Yeah. Oh yeah, and you know, she claimed there was a flood in her apartment, and so like we went in and, you know, she had piles and piles of laundry that looked like she never washed in a million years. And she's like, oh, well, I should be able to have the thing, I should be able to have this every day of the week, the washer. And I said, no, everybody gets it 2 days themselves and then there's one spare day. Oh, well, I have more clothes than you. I said, lady, I told her, I was like, you know, I only have, you know, at the time I only had bras and underwear for 7 days of the week. Exactly seven. Because, like, you know, I was a poor student. I didn't have my mommy and daddy treat me like princess and buy me hooker lingerie. And she was just like, oh. So she went, she laughed at me and she thought that was funny. So she went to Goodwill and started buying me like all different kinds of underwear and put it in a bag and left it by my door. I was so mad. I was like, no, you don't do that, because, you know, those people who give that stuff away sometimes have STDs. And so, yeah, you never get underwear from there. Say what? Yeah, you're not supposed to even get hats or sunglasses there, because hats, people have lice. And so they're stupid and they think, oh. Huh? You don't do what, the hats?
You delouse them.
What's that mean?
Use one of them anti-lice with that style of things.
Dude, I wouldn't even try. I wouldn't even go with that. Like, I wouldn't even try it. It just, that's like asking for problems right there. Like, why would you even want to put your head at risk? Because getting lice is like really difficult to get rid of. So I would never. I would rather buy a hat from Walmart for like a buck than, you know, pay a buck for a used hat at Goodwill. That's just me. It's just not worth it, you know? But, I don't even do that either, because that's another. Socks? Socks from Goodwill, people have, like, again, people will get foot fungus, will say, oh, well, I'm not using this anymore, so somebody else could use this. And they give it to Goodwill, and they're not just giving it away because they want to be generous. They're giving it away because they don't want to use it anymore, so they don't have to continually get.
And that's why you thoroughly wash everything.
You know, even when you thoroughly wash stuff.
The underwear, though, that's just being too close to personal bits there.
Hi, Ragna. Yeah, I mean, I don't know, like.
I don't know a way to delouse underwear, to be honest.
any way that you could actually get a foot fungus, I'm just like, you know what? If you can get sick off this in any way, shape, or form, I ain't doing it. It's just so not worth it. Like, you know, what, you save $1? Not even. Like, you can go to Walmart and get it for, like, cheap.
I save $20 on this book.
Well, books are different, but, like, you know, socks, underwear, things that could carry lice, it's just... I mean, there's a reason why when you go in the Goodwill, it smells like nasty old people in there. They ain't like that because they take care of it.
Hey, do you want us to go back now?
You can add him to the call, sure. Yeah, why don't you add him to the call, because, like, I'm playing. If that's okay with you.
Yep, I know. Just add him.
If you want, you could join the call, too.
I asked you that earlier, and you didn't respond back.
Who did you ask?
I asked you in the Skype thing after.
I didn't pay attention, sorry.
Go ahead, Ryan.
Okay, then.
So what have you done today?
Well, besides, having my body nearly shut down last night, I'm on meds now. Basically, since stress happens, I have to take, like, pain pills to keep my pain down. So, my body starts to act weird. Like, I, like, you know, everything. It's just, yesterday was definitely more shit. Like, it was bad, and it got worse. And then somebody pranked me saying my girlfriend went missing. And I was in fucking tears last night. My girlfriend texted me in the morning. She's like, I'm fine. I can't believe that bastard did that to you. I'm gonna fucking rip his nuts off. I'm like, thanks, babe. Like, seriously, she's my fucking fiance.
Too, but that doesn't make me mental. I mean, there's a difference.
Exactly, and he started saying shit, and then nobody... The mod did ban him, neither did Jess. Twitch got pissed off and banned him from the channel. Twitch did something about it, which was within the funny.
Yes, I have, Jace.
Yeah, Twitch actually banned him from the chat. Like, seriously. He deserved it for being an asshole.
Get even more things about like fantasy and sci-fi.
I personally think the Asperger's, I mean, I know, Asperger's, I think Asperger's or whatever you call it, is not that bad of a, I mean, like, I don't know, like, I've known people like Michael for a long time who've had it, and occasionally Michael will blame his bad life choices on it, but I think that it doesn't matter if you have Asperger's or not. You can make bad life choices based on free will, not based on your mental...
Exactly, you're a complete dick to everybody you know, and my best
socializing with people and cheating on people are way different things.
I wasn't talking about that, I was talking about just socializing in general.
I mean, like, one of the times that you did cheat, you blamed it on your Asperger's, and I was like, really? Like, no.
Why would you use your handicap as a crutch to blame for something that was your own actions? I'm trying not to side with Carrie on this one, but she has a point. I used to use my handicaps as a crutch, and I still do a little bit, because since the shit that happened to me with that female, it's hard for me to get him a job, and my stepmom's like, no, you can still get a job. Dude, I'm a registered sex offender, for fuck's sake. My life is pretty much fucking down the toilet. I'm a level one sex offender. I'm not, like, one that's all over the fucking internet, say, with me plastered on every billboard in every city across the state. No, but it's gonna be hard for me to get a job, so she says it's my fault, and I'm like, no, it wasn't. Bullshit like that. But the thing is, back to this task at hand, my best friend has it as well. And he's a complete dick to me most of the damn time. But I love him to death because he's my best friend, and I'm only his only real-life friend that he has, that I hang out with. And he has people online that he talks with, and a lot of people hate him. But when they start shit with him, I'm there to defend him. I've seen him cry once. Once. And I've never seen Danny cry. Ever. I held him close, and he said if I was a female, he would fuck my brains out, and that scared the shit out of me, because he was babbling like an idiot, and I had to be there for him. It just sucks. It sucks, you know? You gotta take care of your own actions. Handicap does not define who you are, it's your actions that define the person.
Right. Yeah, like, you know, I could say, you know, I was told when I was a kid, I was told by my teachers and to my parents that I could never, ever make it to the middle school. That's what they told me because I had very bad ADD. And you know what? They were wrong because I made it to middle school. And not only did I make it to middle school...
Oh, sorry, I had my shirt off. It's fucking hot in here. Like, seriously, it's like, it feels like it's 80 degrees in here.
Oh, that's so cool. Yeah. Did you see that, Kill Cam?
I seen the one where you shot the elk in the knee.
Yeah, you'll see this one coming up, and it's really cool. But
right at the bunker in that. Yep, right up there, bud.
Yeah, it was from far away too. But yeah, so I mean, you know, like they told me that I could never make it.
Oh my god, that shot though! That shot though! Arrow to the butthole.
I know, it was good.
You should make that as a highlight for fuck's sake.
I should, but yeah, like, you know. I know that I have my problems, you know, with focusing, but, you know something? I'll tell you something about me. They told me I couldn't even make it to the middle school. Well, I didn't know. I made it to middle school, and not only that, when I got to high school, I was on honor roll for 4 fucking years. 4 years, and I was, like, the vice president of the Little G team, and I did piano and modeling, and, you know, I did, like...
Go fuck yourself. Look at how popular I am. What did you guys do with your pathetic lives? Nothing.
Right.
I'm fucking climbing the ladder. You're
right. And you know, the teachers are the ones that told this to my parents. And, you know, I could have sat there and let this define my life, but I didn't. And, you know, not only that, Michael, guess what? I got a scholarship, many scholarships to go to college. One of them was the Bright Future Scholarship that paid for 75% of my schooling. I would have gotten more if I had gotten straight A's all 4 years, but I decided to do more volunteering than focusing on schoolwork. But I still graduated. My senior year, I had straight A's. my whole senior year, and then like for all 4 years I had a 3.85 GPA, so I had a pretty good GPA. And you know, I'm just saying this because I want you to know that I think that you're smarter than you give yourself credit for. And
exactly, you're an intelligent guy, dude. All the shit that you know about video games, Warhammer, dude, I was fucking amazed that most of my friends don't remember all this shit, and you fucking gave me flat out storylines of each character, and that was fucking amazing.
Yeah, like, you have good.
You're a fantastic guy, and you know what? You're great, and I'm not the only one who, like, respect. I'm like, I have much respect for you. Like,
yeah,
seriously.
We do. So, like, you know, when I had you be a commander in my military, I had you be a commander in my military because I knew that you had. Smart, that you were really smart, just like Jace is very smart. And you guys, I know you think your Asperger's is bad, but it's not. Like, I wouldn't even have noticed it had you not told me, and I still don't even, like, recognize it. You seem like normal people to me.
Exactly. You don't. Cause, yeah, I talk too much. What do you freaking do? Everybody does. A lot of people do.
That's okay. I'm a girl and I talk a lot too.
Oh, God, this boss is pissing me off.
Who?
I'm fighting a thing in Darksiders 2. Fighting this thing called the Constructor Hulk. Fucking annoying. Oh my god, Jesus. I'm getting frickin' dunked on. I've been saying that a lot ever since I played Marvel.
But yeah, my point being here is I don't. Because I know how smart you guys are, I don't accept the excuse for your actions of being that you have Asperger's. Because I know you're smart and you have potential and you are aware of your actions. So, like,
exactly.
Remember the other day I told you that, you know, until you come with a ring, I'm gonna go and date other people? You had a reaction. You were mad. You were upset. So it's not like you don't understand what you're doing. You do understand what you're doing. Because when I told you I would do the same back to you, you definitely did not like it. So my suggestions to you is that you need to figure out what you want in this life, and you have to realize you can't have your cake and eat it too. You have to pick what you want.
Do you want to be with her or do you want to find someone else? It's your choice, man. Trust me. It's been a hard choice for me because, hell, I was, to tell you the truth, you probably guys are going to hate me, I was dating two people at the same time. I was juggling my boyfriend and this girl, Christina, the girl that you know. And
yeah.
And I left my boyfriend because one reason, he was just too weak, he was too pathetic, he didn't stand up for himself, and I didn't want to be the one who has to hold his hand through everything. So, yes, his dad was a college professor, but still, I didn't want to have to deal with the bullshit and the drama that his family had. But Christina had a lot more on her plate with the drug abuse and the fucking drinking, and she got raped a few times at parties, and it wasn't her fault. I was there for her, and you know what? I stuck with her.
I mean, it's good that you...
I chose the best choice because she needed me more than Van did.
Well, I mean, I don't support... I mean, I'm not going to knock you for making your own decisions because your decisions are your own. You're not, like, my boyfriend or anything. But I am going to say this. If you feel a liking towards someone... You should, you know, if you like two people at once, you should take time to decide what you want.
I did. I thought over it. Countless days I was thinking who I should pick. And none of my friends like Christina is the best choice. And I'm not going to take your guys' opinion. This is mine alone. This is my choice. I was depicting and I picked Christina because one reason. She has three jobs, she works very hard, she's a caring woman, and will be there for me, and be moral support for me when every time I got hurt, Van was never
Hey, Dragonstar.
He never helped me when I was sad. He never coddled me when shit went down. He was always hiding in the corner, being a bitch, and not even standing up for his own boyfriend, so I left him for that reason alone, that he didn't stand up for me. A relationship, they're supposed to be there for each other. Every time shit went down with him, I was there. Every time. Was he there for me? Half the time? No. So I made the best choice, and I picked the one that I'd rather be with.
Well, I was always there for Michael, so I don't think that was a problem for us. But what I think,
like, everybody has their problem.
I'm just gonna say it's just me being a fucking idiot. That's what's happened.
You gotta think things through, man. You always gotta think things through. You don't just rush into things as far as.
Sometimes I overthink. Sometimes I don't think about it enough.
Well,
like when I went. Sorry.
I think that in life, I mean, if you really want to live a bachelor life. That's something you should. Well, if you don't want to do that, you shouldn't do that. I mean, I'm gentle with you.
I don't plan as far ahead as other people sometimes.
Well, that's part of being a man in life and a woman. You know, being an adult is planning your life. You can't always live a life of a bachelor if you want to have someone take you seriously, because, you know, life is too short, and, you know, people don't have time for that. I don't have time for that.
Yeah, nobody lives forever, I know that.
Exactly, and, you know, it's, alright, here's an example for you. When you're, it's kind of hard to explain, but, you know, life does not come to those who stand still. It comes to those who seek opportunity and look for it. A woman's not going to come into your life if you're going to sit on your ass and do nothing about it. You have to get out there on your own 2 feet, get off your ass, and do it yourself in order to find somebody. I'm not trying to be a dick, but, Mike, you got to get up on your own 2 feet, and you walk, and then you run, and then you keep going, bust down every fucking door that gets in your way, and continue.
I think that.
Huh?
Well.
Bruce?
Oh, it's still on. Let's see. I think Gary cut out.
Oh, I didn't cut out. I just stopped talking for a minute.
But.
But yeah, I mean, I don't know. Like, I'm nice about what's going on because, like, huh?
He was asking my headset. Mine are Turtle Beaches.
I hate Turtle Beach. Turtle Beach. I have, but it doesn't work and batteries like go out really quick. Like, it drains them.
You should always have like some form of, like, all my stuff. I usually try to keep it like wired. The guests can have the wireless stuff.
I don't really like it.
I use wireless controllers because I do have a wired controller, but that's for Enter the Gungeon in any PC-based game that I use. I use a controller when it comes to third-person or first-person games, or top-down shooters, or things like Doom. I use a controller because I hate using the mouse and keyboard because my fingers cramp up.
Whereas I need to get a whole new mouse and headset. All my stuff is wired. I'm just gonna tell you that. From the computer to the internet connection to the TV, everything is wired together.
Like, my brother got me a wired thing for my Xbox, but the funny thing is, if you look, I'll turn my thingy. If you look and see that thing right there, through there, is my downstairs, and the router's right there, so I get 100% connection.
Yeah, I just connect directly with the cord, so I'm always 100% connection.
Like, the funny thing is that I had to use my Xbox in my brother's room for a longest time, so I had to deal with his obnoxious snoring, shit like that. But the thing is, the wireless connection for Twitch, I could barely stream because it would kick me off. because the wireless connection from there was shit. So when I got in my room and I got my flat screen TV, which is freaking beastly, by the way. Where the fuck is it?
What's the size of it?
32-inch.
My computer screen is a 55.
I really don't care if you're using a TV for a computer screen.
Yeah, I really wish I had.
But it's pretty cool though to have a huge, so you can see the battlefield a little bit bigger when you're playing with like, hammer.
It's a little bit easier to aim at things with a big TV.
Oh yeah, the new Warhammer.
It's less pixel hunting.
Out.
The Total War Warhammer.
Yeah, it's already out.
Yeah, I've seen somebody playing it with like the steam tanks and stuff. I really want to play it. I also want to play Dawn of War 3 and a bunch of other games. There's so many different games I want to play now.
I know, right?
Like Battlefield 1. World War 1. Trench based battles using a Mark, I think it's a Mark 4, Liberty tank, which is the British tank of the era.
And the funny thing is that, you know, it's kind of hard for me to say because, you know, like, one day, if ever, I would want to visit Carrie, you know, just to see her once, you know, because, you know, it'd be great to hang out with my best friend and just chill with her, play Skyrim and just have a good laugh and stuff like that. That's why I made her stream every time she streams when you tell me, Mike, and things saying, oh, Luna's streaming, I want to be there, because one, I'm a mod, and the funny thing is, barely people come in, and it's just usually us family just talking and chatting and having a good time.
Yeah, I usually have her Twitch stream up all the time, so I know whenever she comes in.
I don't, because I have like 100,000 streamers that I watch, but this one guy.
It doesn't matter who else I'm watching, I usually have one window just reserved for her.
Yeah, because Carrie's awesome.
A legendary dragon. They're about a one of those before.
I just like the picture I sent Carrie. And bunny, did you put all the bunnies? I was like, I saw that on
DVD. Bunny thing, yeah, I seen it.
Yeah, I found that on DeviantArt, so I had to send it to Gary.
You ever played Star Trek Online?
You asked me that before.
I always forget who I ask what.
And it's funny, my friend Danny does the same thing. Like, he constantly does, but it doesn't bother her as much. He's like, oh. Like, yeah.
Update my World of Warships or any other games. The last thing I updated was Armored Warfare, and I haven't played it in about a week.
She's so concentrated on that, fighting that dragon.
Yeah, I'm like,
That's a legendary dragon with Frostbrand. Versus a woman who's almost naked.
Leave my pony alone. Caliente is hot in Spanish.
Caliente, hold on.
It's also known as CBB. And it's a female body. Apparently there's new versions of it. Although I would have highly recommended that there were new areas.
Hell, there's a mod where it's really fucked up. One of my friends found every time you die, a monster fucks you. So, I was playing it, so I'm sitting there playing it, and I got killed by a ghost, and I got killed by a bum.
Wow.
I'm sorry, the joke was
that's one.
Yeah, imagine getting killed by a bunch of fucking dragon and just take off the
eyes. No, the thing is, with the skeletons, is it necrophilia?
You know, Andrew had necrophilia. He liked. I've absorbed like 3 dragon souls today.
You know. And it's funny, the funny thing is, everybody thinks that he can define me and say that I'm a dick. I'm only a dick because you treat me like shit. If you treat me nice, I'm a really awesome guy. You notice when you guys welcomed me to the chat and were nice and not assholes. You notice how nice I was.
We tend not to be assholes on this one.
Exactly, that's
what, we tend to be a pretty cool crowd.
Like people who say Thrasher dicks or, you know, you're gonna get raped and things like that. Yeah, that's the people who usually get raped.
Dude, I can't wait till someone comes in because my band finger's been getting itchy. I swear to God, one day, if you guys get raided, I'm gonna be on that 100%. Me and Mike are gonna be getting shots fired. They're gonna be the casualties.
I've been practicing a little bit in that Battlefield Hardline game.
I gotta start playing it more with you. Me and you.
I started playing the Conquest mode and I am completely sucking Conquest.
That's why we do Team Deathmatch, man. You have to play
with Team Deathmatch has no vehicles though. I've read it over and it has no vehicles at all.
Oh yeah, I remember now because
the Conquest modes only have the vehicles.
Yeah, because the maps are the big maps.
I'm good at long range and Battlefront. Go figure. I'm very good at short range with Hardline, very good at long range with Battlefront.
I need to get Battlefront again because I got rid of it because, you know, it just moved the shit out of me because none of my friends played it anymore. And then I bumped into you guys and then I found out you guys play it, so I feel stupid for selling it. Now I feel like an idiot. But it was for a birthday present for my friend that I bought him something because his grandparents fucked him over, so I sacrificed a bunch of my shit just to help him out. I was gonna buy it for myself, you know?
See, Carrie got hers, I think. Carrie, when did you get your Battlefront? About the same time I got mine?
Around the same time, yeah.
Yeah, I gave her some Xbox cards in order for her to get it because Jeremy, instead of buying it for her, bought it for himself.
What a dick. Jesus, Carrie, what's up with the asshole men in your life? Jesus Christ, I want to sue every single one of them.
You know, I think what it is I'm just a very nice person. And then,
I think they
take advantage of me because I'm so nice. And they do.
You should
I hate it. What?
Me too. You should fucking just unleash all holy hell on them one day. They start shit with you and you just go full on fucking
rage. I mean, like, you know, I mean, Michael, for example, he's close to me, but, like, even he takes advantage of me at some times, and I don't know, I actually, the other day, it was not even, like, yesterday, and I was pretty much dying inside, like, feeling like, ugh, like, I feel like I'm just not meant to be on this planet anymore, because people do this to me, no matter how nice I am.
No, don't give up, you have us. Can't give up, and I'm not gonna let you give up.
Where the hell are these two people? Did they really just take the long way around those two people?
Who, me?
Those two people, Delphine and the other guy. Did they just really take the long way around just to catch up to you?
Yeah, pretty much.
God, yeah, I'm passing, and this is sometimes dumb.
No shit, especially when that stupid bitch, Lita, or whatever the fuck her name is, gets in the way.
Lydia,
whatever the fuck the dog's name is, I really don't care.
Fun fact, Ragnar, did you know that Lydia actually uses the male walking model? Like, all the male animations. She looks like a male? She uses the male animation model.
That's fucking great, babe.
It's fucking great, because that proves that Lydia has a dick underneath.
People always want to marry her, it drives me nuts.
No. If you're marrying anyone, you're either marrying Serana, if you're a guy. I can't remember which
I can use the platform.
That crab just literally came after me onto the bridge, really?
Just like, come at me, bro.
I remember playing this, it's been so long. I need to get, you know, I really wish the spirit mods would work properly.
Let's keep moving.
You know, where you could actually use it with the shield properly instead of it's waving like a sword.
I wish you could fight creatures underwater. Like, actually fight the creature.
Yeah, that used to be a thing in Oblivion where you could, you know, swing a sword at a creature underwater.
Dragon wants to munch me.
They actually have a mod, I think, that does that.
How they got a player versus player mod in Oblivion, it's a server somebody made.
Underwater fighting mod. Allow attacking in water at Skyrim Nexus.
Yeah, like, I get bit by the fish and then, like, I can't fight them underwater. And then you get to the surface and you're still screwed. And there's always, like, a creature.
Fucking dill hole, Jesus Christ. You fucking wrecking like shit. I almost have you dead, you stupid douche.
Sure. Who are you coming?
I'm fighting a thing called a Constructor Hulk. Really fucking annoying.
Constructor Hulk?
It's like a giant stone golem, and it's really annoying. It's a boss. Our players do.
Oh, is that the one where
he plays death?
Yeah, I was gonna say, it's partially played as, I guess, Brother War. I remember it was like
the
four, it was the sort of
four horsemen. Yeah, the four horsemen of the apocalypse, and I fucking wrecked this shit.
Oh, it's a forsworn.
Yeah, the blue mountain flowers also give you health if you mix them, right?
Just don't eat any blue mountain oysters.
Blue mountain oysters?
Be careful. The forsworn are just as dangerous.
Okay, right, Matt, right. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, so I know. I've heard that.
Yeah, it's fucking hilarious because to my streamers that I watch, one streamer that I watch, she's adopted from Russia, and she lives in New Zealand. So we were talking about stuff from New Zealand and shit. And I was wondering what the definitions were, and I heard "fanny" meant with a pussy, and I'm like, oh my god, that is awesome.
You didn't know that meant pussy?
No, I never met anybody from New Zealand. I'm fucking serious. It's a known fact. I haven't.
Lead on to Skyhaven Temple.
I know people from Australia, and most of them are dickwads. Some of the streamers are okay, but some of them I wanted to punch them in the fucking throat.
This girl looks like a faggot, and I don't mean that in the gay sense either. She's like
starting to hate people from Texas.
This girl that joined her chat that's like, oh my gosh, let me touch my butt and I'm part of the military. I really resent.
Oh, are you talking about IMBU? If you were talking about Twitch, I would have banned her instantly if she was talking shit.
No, I'm talking about on IMBU. Like, she's
touching her backside in IMBU.
She's showing off her butt trying to join. And she's wearing a bow.
Jesus is asking her to do a security check.
Yeah, ask her if she's got a Skype. Watch, she'll say no.
She's a spy. I have a bad feeling in my chest right now. No. And I'm fucking serious.
See? She said no.
Alright.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye, then.
Like, I swear, it's probably a gay guy on a girl account. You know, we get so many gay guys coming in.
Yeah.
said that thing looks like Michael when it's pissed off. When he's pissed off. They call him not Golem. He fucking saw this thing. It's giant. It's like the thing on steroids.
I think it's after, I have never actually gotten really angry. I may ask Paul what the hell happened there, but that's pretty much just me voicing what the hell I'm thinking at that moment. I've never actually really angry.
Man, Saya was so mad at you yesterday. Holy shit, she looked like she was gonna rip your jugular out.
Who pissed off who? Mike, did you fucking piss somebody off?
Yeah, he did.
Who's pissed at me for a long time?
Who's pissed at you for a long time?
Saya.
Well, I mean, you kinda used her like a napkin.
Don't do that to people, trust me.
I mean, I know you don't like it when I talk about this, but kind of, like, I just kind of bottle it up all the time, and then I don't have anyone to talk to about it. I mean, I could talk to Jeremy about it, and I could talk to Jace about it, but then you would be mad that way.
I'll listen to anything people have to say, because they're my friends, and that's what I do.
Hanging moss.
Hanging moss is used for potions, too.
A lot of things are used for potions. It's the same, you can't use a sword for potions.
Is that on there? If that's the way you want it.
Or, you know, have potions that can fail if you add the wrong ingredient.
Like, hey, Kara, I think I found a picture of me and you if we were, like, really as close friends. It's okay. Me as I'm a wolf and a bunny, and you're a bunny. I found this earlier.
So, one of you is a bunny and the other one's a bunny.
She's a bunny and I'm the wolf.
I'm pretty sure I've probably seen this photo before. Yeah, I've seen that style photo before.
Yep. Me and Christina have this bunny wolf thing going on. It's kind of a thing.
Yeah, I'm usually like a tank player. I think you're like animals.
Oh, come on, picture. Don't fucking dirt on me. Picture that I want to send it. It's weird that sometimes Skype goes to your room.
Is it the one where that bunny's in the pool?
Yeah.
I've seen that one.
Yeah. I'm really worried about my girlfriend. Like, seriously, she's been working so fucking hard. We don't really talk as much, but I know she loves me and I know she's busy. There's a wedding coming up that she has to go to.
Question, are you afraid of clowns?
No.
My friend Travis was. Oh god.
That's a weird looking clown.
That's Pennywise, the clown from Stephen King of It.
Oh my god, that is adorable. Kinda looks like me when I'm fucking psychotic.
Well, clowns are kind of creepy looking.
You wanna know what's funny? Never watch Hillary Clinton on the face of
the world. Yeah, doesn't scare me. I just don't
like it. You're like my friend Travis. I shoot my friend, but my friend Devin drew a picture of clown slid underneath his face while he was like, he sees it, freaks out, runs into the locker, runs out of the fucking classroom, screaming like a bitch. It was hilarious. I didn't even tell him to do it, like seriously. He just did it on his own, free will, and he's like, so.
Oh, this is what I said. No, this is that one game. I chose the wrong fucking photo. Because I'm a big derp. I was trying to get a picture of my starship in Star Trek Online. There we go. It's the one right above it.
I'm not afraid of you.
Man, if you thought our group has drama, by the way, you should see the old group.
I gave up this
They actually did things to cause drama on purpose. I remember your brother tried to date me in Thornton.
Yeah, I remember that too.
And your mom has not talked to me since I basically told him that I wasn't interested.
No, like seriously. Like the funny thing is, I'm not gonna say anything, but I know Harry never feels towards me at all in that sense. Because you know what, if he doesn't like me in that kind of sense, even if I was single, it doesn't bother me one bit. Because I could tell if Gary had feelings for me, because I kind of feel those kind of things.
Wait, who has feelings for you?
If you did, I would have noticed easily. I see the signs very easily, and you know, you're more like
it would have been like a notice me senpai like thing.
Yeah, but she's more. I consider Gary to be super attractive, super adorable. But she's meant to be with somebody else, and I got Christina, I'm engaged, I'm happy for who I'm with, and I consider Carrie like a big sister to me, more than anything, and Michael and Jay is my brothers. So you guys are the biggest family I have on Twitch, because anything I need, I go to Carrie. If I start crying, Carrie's always there for me. Most of the damn time, if she's not sleeping, or...
pooping.
Or taking a poop. That, you know, you guys are the greatest people on Twitch. I have another stream family that I hang out with, but you guys help me out the most.
I just found this golden gem in one of my other files. It should have been under pictures, but it wasn't.
What golden gem?
I think I found Carrie's picture.
Who?
It's funny. Who would not want who would want not want this, man? Dude, look at this, man. Fucking smoking hot.
He's peeing above us, man. That was the only answer he's clicked up right now.
Yeah, you wanna know what?
Man, look at me, I'm thermal. I have to use Photoshop to make my abs look bigger.
He's so dumb, like why do you even bother?
I swear I know who this anime character is, but I can't put my finger on it.
Seven Deadly Sins.
Yep, it's Vaughn, the fox sin. The sin of greed. You can't die, you drink from the fountain of youth, and pretty much, he could get decapitated, chopped into 100 pieces, and still survive, or get disintegrated.
He's anime Deadpool.
He's better than Deadpool.
Deadpool can't die.
Oh, actually, he's been disintegrated and still came back.
So is Deadpool.
So is Wolverine. In an alternate universe, Wolverine actually got shot by a sentinel and nothing but his adamantium skeleton remained and he died completely. And he was dead in that universe. And it's actually canon, which is funny.
Whereas Deadpool has been stripped down to a single atom and he's been able to regrow from that atom.
Man, I bet my dick feels big in this hand.
You watched the movie.
I saw the movie in theaters, but
fucking great. I have to admit, that was a fun one.
My dad loved it. My dad fucking thought it was hilarious. My mom even was laughing so hard. Like, yeah, seriously.
It's the same thing, like, I really want to watch this movie called Sausage Party.
Is it good?
I've shown you the preview before for it, right?
Oh, you want to hear something fucked up? I was watching this guy on YouTube. This handicapped kid, alright, this is fucked up.
Evil Petra put me here. Stole my tower. Hater. Chew your bones. Let me out. Kind.
And fucking everybody was racist towards this kid because he was black.
Because you are such a nice
video of the YouTuber who was talking about current events and shit, and it's... You know how all that drama on YouTube has happened? No. Well, all the YouTubers are banding together that caused all this drama. Markiplier, PewDiePie.
Oh, I'm wearing the Nocturnal armor, Dragonstar.
They joined together to help H3H3 win this fucking lawsuit against the guy because the guy got all pissy because they review YouTube videos and make fun of them, and the guy was suing them for saying,
"How do I open this?"
Comments about this guy, joking around, and he took it too far and sued for a shit ton of money, and it's just gonna take 2 years and blah blah blah. The fucked up thing is, the cool thing is, all these YouTubers even are banding together to donate money to help this guy, to help these guys, and they've already made over $100,000, $101,000 right now, and it's still going. And I bet you these bastards, these guys are gonna win the lawsuit because one reason, it's fair use. And the funny thing is, the judge and jury won't probably understand fair use because they don't use fucking YouTube because they're old fashioned. So it might be up in the air and this fucker might win, but if they have enough money, they can easily just be like, you know what, I got the money, I can fix everything again. But if their YouTube channel gets shut down, then everything, and they probably will lose their house, they'll probably lose everything, and probably end up on the streets, and you know what, I hope this fucking guy gets what's coming to him. He's like the surreal fucking YouTube. A piece of shit that doesn't need to exist in this universe, or any universe to be exact. It's rude to do this to somebody, because somebody said something about your video in a review doesn't give you the right to get all fucking so happy about it.
What happened? Shit, did I lock her in it?
Lead on, Sky Haven Temple.
You'll have to speak up. I'm a little deaf in my right ear.
Last time I remember, this woman dies. But you look cool stuff.
No fine upstairs to boil eyes.
Time to end this. Hey,
hold on.
Is the Wi-Fi being wacky on your end?